now, here's meteorologist Michelle Muscatello with your live Pinpoint Doppler 12 Futurecast.
All right, Michelle, you may be nervous this morning, so I had a 2:30 tea time, moved it up to 1:30.
I think that was a smart move. I think so, because, you know, the later we get into this afternoon and this evening, the better your chance of seeing a shower or a thunderstorm. And I'm actually watching the radar very closely, because just over the last, say, 15 minutes, I'm seeing what looks to be a developing shower just to the west of 395 in eastern Connecticut. I'll keep an eye on it. It's pretty harmless right now, but the atmosphere certainly primed as the day goes on today for some stronger showers and thunderstorms to develop. And this could push to the east, too. I think by and far the bulk of the action for us won't arrive until later on this evening, probably as Patrick is wrapping up his golf game. Live City Cam pictures. We've got that hazy sun and cloud mix out over Providence right now. I mean, ultra sticky air today. The humidity is at 77%, the temperature 82, and winds out of the south-southeast at 13 miles an hour. Our weather spotters for the most part reporting low 80s. Caitlin in Warwick says it's humid. Robert in Fall River says muggy and overcast. And Jim says it's hazy and muggy at his house. And it's not just them noticing it. I mean, the dew point right now is running at about 74 degrees. So on our dew point scale, that is certainly in the oppressive category. And we are going to keep with this high humidity, and that helps fuel these thunderstorms that will likely develop as the afternoon and evening goes on. About 83 right now, Smithfield, 81 in Johnston, 81 Greenwich Bay Manor in East Greenwich, and 79 at Bank Newport. Here's the weather alert already just 2 hours west. We are under a severe thunderstorm watch for western Massachusetts and parts of Connecticut, including Hartford. Now, this wouldn't surprise me. This comes from the Storm Prediction Center out in Oklahoma. Wouldn't surprise me if they ended up extending it into our area, too, and maybe going later into the evening until maybe as late as 11 or midnight for us. So right now, the watch issued out of our area, but we are under the threat for severe storms, too. Already starting to see these scattered thunderstorms and showers firing up 2 hours west. It's happening out ahead of a cold front, but it's in all of this warm, muggy air that we have in place right now that these showers and storms are starting to develop. And just the lightning tracker here, starting to see those cloud-to-ground lightning strikes, too. So as we head towards this afternoon, hazy, hot, and humid, a spot shower or thunderstorm in the afternoon, but a much better chance this evening, about 85 to 90. And once again, we're concerned about the potential for severe weather. Damaging winds, hail, dangerous lightning, and torrential downpours are all possible in any of these severe thunderstorms. And timing-wise, I'm looking at the evening, probably after 5 or 6 for the strongest of the storms to head our way. But, you know, even this afternoon, can't rule out a stray shower in Central Falls, about 87 in Rumford, 88 downtown. TF Green into the upper 80s, Cranston close to 90, and that heat index will be in the 90s at times with the high humidity. At the coastline, you've been having a tougher time getting rid of the clouds. I think clouds and a little hazy sun in Narragansett, 84, about 80. 86 at URI, upper 80s when Saucon and Pawtucket, sticky, very warm with that shower or thunderstorm possible. This afternoon in Swansea, about 86 in New Bedford. The beaches then, clouds and a little hazy sun. It's not a great beach day, about 82 for an air temp, water temperature at 73. On the bay, if you're planning on taking an evening boat ride, definitely watch the skies because we could see quickly changing conditions out in the skies, including for the first part of the night tonight. Evening showers and thunderstorms, then some late night clearing after, say, 1 or 2 in the morning, the sky should start to clear up and we'll be left with some sunshine and a very nice day Thursday. It's my pick of the work week this week with temperatures in the mid and upper 80s and those dry skies. Keeping an eye on that system out in the Caribbean right now, heading towards the Bahamas, not defined yet as a depression or a tropical storm, but it could be named here in the next day or two. For us, we're still looking at some isolated thunderstorms towards the end of the week and the weekend. Hot this weekend. There may finally be a little bit of relief early next week. You can get your updated forecast and live Pinpoint Doppler 12 radar 24 hours a day on the Pinpoint Weather Station. It's Cox Digital Cable Channel 125. It's a good source because we have the live radar streaming 24/7 on that site.
Well, hopefully it doesn't rain because that's the only thing that's going to be able to stop me against these jokers I'm playing golf against.
Well, I actually want it to rain because I don't have to water my garden then. So we've got dueling forecasts here.
After 5:30, can we compromise? Deal? Okay.
All right, that's fair. All right.
Thanks,
I'll see what I can do.
Yeah,
for
Mother
Nature.